Captain's Log, Day 34 of the Sophomore Chesed mission to Mars. Our journey has been fraught with peril, but the morale of the sophomores is still high.
I can't believe we get to be the first first grade to go on a Chesed mission to Mars.
We'll finally be able to practice all that Martian language we've been learning with Rabbi Shahak.
I sure hope the locals appreciate all the old coats and fresh swag we're bringing them.
This is epic.
But I heard the hotel is a dump.
Yeah, who knew the Raleigh would colonize on Mars before us?
I'm just so excited. Guys, let's sing.
Our ship is going to Mars. Gonna have a fun-filled week with Martians. La-dee-da. Mars to Mars. We're going to Mars. We're only alive.
They must want to harness our spirit of inquiry to power their alien technologies.
Brace yourself for a crash landing.
God, what is this? This is disgusting. It makes no sense. I'm looking at a bunch of orangutans out there. Where is the art? Where is the acting? Where is the passion?
When I look back at that movie, I don't know. I think it changed us all. Forever.
The dinner theme that year was the future, and the committee tasked us with making a film that would make people actually feel the future in the present. The kind of thing that had never been even tried before.
My movie was going to combine it all. The sci-fi, the musical, the drama. It was going to be Citizen Kane meets A Toy Story 3 meets A Toy Story 1. I didn't like it too. It was too sad.
Rabbi Senior said we could spend whatever we wanted on special effects. There was essentially no budget. He said we could always have a second dinner to raise the funds.
I don't get it. People have dinner every night. Why not?
The producers got involved and told us we were trying to do too much. And they were going to take the film in an entirely different direction.
We're gonna take this in an entirely different direction.
Is it still about the future?
No.
So do we still have to make a video for the dinner?
Yes.
All right, let's hear you read the second paragraph on page 18, the student number 3.
Wow, this school is so amazing. Learning is the best. So, did I get it?
This school is so amazing. Learning is the best.
Learning is the beast.
The line is the best.
And why did you guys write B-E-S-T?
I wasn't in class because I was meeting with college guidance.
Hey, are you talking to me? Are you talking to me? I was in college guidance.
You want the truth? You can't handle the truth. I was with college guidance.
Early drafts of the script didn't impress. The suits at the studio felt the film was missing real star power. It needed a name. Something to really get the audience fired up. Something timeless. And that's when we reached out to the ultra-popular duo, Nachi Paul Simon and Batya Garfunkel, to write the soundtrack.
You could feel it when they arrived in the studio. This was going to be something special.
And here's to you, Dr. Edward Finn. Students love you more than you will know.
Show a little bit about Frisch to our guests. Student-centered learning at its best. Look around you as you see our students grow and thrive. Stroll around the grounds until you feel alive.
And here's to you. Heaven holds a place for
new direction of the film, it wasn't long before creative differences came to the surface.
I cannot stand part of this production! This is not art! This is the pop culture! Pop! I tell you, as Jean-Pierre Fernandes once said, film is not an amusement park, it is a liberation of the soul, like a little hummingbird!
Sir, I'm gonna need your lens.
Oh, you cannot do this to me! Do you know who I am? You do not understand
what yeah, I am. Nobody missed that guy.
With the old director gone, the duo went full steam ahead, producing the next hit track for the film.
Hello, chemist, my old friend. I've got email from you again. Because my phone is always beeping.
You got mail.
It's too bad that I was sleeping. But the lesson that was planted in my brain still remains. About the sound of kindness. In restless halls I walk along, went to school and joined the throng. Beneath the premise of a school program, I had a feeling that it was a sham. Then my eyes were grabbed by the Sharia breakout.
Is when the lawyers got involved.
Apparently, we didn't have the rights to those songs.
The lawsuits were coming in fast and furious and threatened to sink the film.
Where was the school council on that one?
So we were back to square one. No director, no music, and that's when we got our breakthrough.
Hollywood loves a good comeback story, and sports movies were all the rage. Rocky, Rudy, Airbud, but could we find the right sound?
Guys, you gotta hear this.
What is it?
It's called ABBA.
The ABBA?
Well, ABBA Cassidy. They're a cover band.
Apparently, that was copyrighted also.
We kept getting into trouble with the sound, so we decided to cut it all together, keep things a little more simple.
Wait, what? Why is nobody talking?
I
I didn't even do anything.
I don't know. Everyone was just acting so weird. That teacher is always picking on me.
Yeah, test audiences hated that. For a film about the future, we just kept feeling like we were going backwards.
Listen, fellas, I know you're trying your best, but your best is the worst. A silent movie? What were you thinking? You're burning the money. And honestly, I think it's time we gotta bring somebody with a little more experience.
Oh, not that guy again.
And then, let me tell you, I do the research while I was gone. And the children these days, they're all listening to big Broadway musicals.
Nope.
Well, some of the children. I have it. Why did I not think of it all along? The dinner. Dr. Bergman. Annie. We will do the Annie with a sci-fi.
No sci-fi.
A little sci-fi.
I totally saved the day. My idea was genius. Ann Berkman was cast as the lead, and those lazy writers finally started producing some original work.
You're never fully dressed without a smile.
Or collar.
Collar. Genius!
A song about a freshman on the first day of school.
By the time the movie was in previews, we knew we had a hit on our hands.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us. Seven Starbucks, we got 10. Seven One Jack, we got 10. It's a hard life for us. The place is always hopping. Don't it seem like there's never any glass? Once a day, don't you worry, don't it drop in? It seems that school's going by so fast. So many calls.
It felt like we were finally getting traction, and this was going to be huge.
What was our movie about? I don't know. Some people would like to say family, friends, aliens, sports. A little something for everyone. But I think we all learned something here. Don't make the dinner video the day before the dinner.